Welcome everybody to Game Sushi. My name is Alex and tonight I'm doing something a bit different. As many of you know, Cyberpunk released patch 1.62 and with it they implemented Intel XeSS, or as I'm going to refer to it for the rest of this as Intel XS, just because it's easier for me to say. Now on the screen you'll notice that it shows average frames per second of 96 frames. Now I'm showing that because this was a benchmarking run I did when I was not capturing in OBS simultaneously. When I do capture in OBS simultaneously, the frames per second isn't as high. From what I saw, generally, while capturing in OBS, I'm gonna get about a 10 frames per second decrease. So I'm just showing you the screen because if you have an Intel Arc GPU, just feel confident that you're gonna have a great experience with Intel XS turned on as well. I'll show you what the settings are that I'm using in a little bit, but I want to do a benchmark while I'm capturing in OBS so that you can see the exact decrease from these exact same settings. Still using super sampling, only difference will be on this next run that I'm also capturing simultaneously in OBS. Okay, so you can see that I have the Intel XS set to auto and the sharpness by default is set to 50. And again, if you remember what our frames per second were, the average frames per second before, this will be a good comparison so you can see the decrease in OBS so that the rest of the changes I make a little bit more sense. Plus, if you're planning on streaming or maybe even just capturing gameplay on your Intel Arc GPU, then you're going to be getting well over 60 frames per second. Now, something I would like to mention about this patch is that generally I've seen quite a substantial performance increase just across the board. Earlier, I tried playing without any super sampling, and I was getting about 20 to 30 FPS more than just last week when I was trying to just play the game and enjoy it with FSR turned on. So whatever CD Projekt Red did to optimize this game, whatever improvements they did, whether they removed CPU overhead or addressed it in some way or whatever they did, basically they've made this game run way better. Way better. And I don't think this will be limited to just those of us that use Intel Arc GPUs. I think everybody across the board, whether you're an NVIDIA card or AMD, I think you're gonna have a good time. Now you can see the average FPS went down. It went down because I'm capturing in OBS. But now the settings that I'm going to change are going to make a little bit more sense. So let's put it on Intel XS Ultra Quality and see if there's any difference. And then let me show you the things that I've turned off here. These sliders, I switched to the off position because they were kind of tanking performance before. And these are all the exact same settings I was running as of last week. So basically things that I've turned off that I found I could live without, that don't make the game look like complete doo-doo, but things I just did to try and get whatever FPS I could. Because, I mean, whether it was on 1080p or just 1440, it was rough. Really rough. So I'm gonna go down and show you, but if you're wondering why a lot of these sliders are turned off, again, these were the settings I was running as of last week. So really the only difference, as you see that I have things, a lot of things on medium, some things off, low. These are just the things that I did to try and improve my performance because prior to today, performance was just a little bit better than unplayable, but not what you would expect of a modern card with 16 gigs of VRAM. So we're on ultra quality. We're going to run this benchmark again. And really the only difference, as soon as this patch came out, I downloaded it, and all I literally did was turn Intel Access to on, to the auto position. And I mean, the performance increase has just been massive, massive. So ultra quality, yeah, the FPS went down a little bit, but not by much. So I mean, if you're not capturing gameplay, you're gonna be getting great FPS. I think we've pretty much seen that. I mean, really capturing while changing all this stuff is worst case scenario for the GPU. So I mean, even if you're the type of person, you're a content creator and you want to get into maybe streaming with the Arc GPU, or you know, capturing gameplay, now you can actually do it in Cyberpunk. So yeah, this path tracing thing is just nuts. I saw how like there are 4090s out there that are struggling with that, and I'm not messing with it, but let's see how it runs with some ray tracing. The setting is still Intel Access ultra quality with ray tracing. And then lastly, once this is done, we'll check out what ray tracing is like with the Intel Access setting on the auto. Okay, I know I keep saying it, but keep in mind, we'd be probably around 10 FPS higher at this setting if I wasn't capturing an OBS. Now, let's change it from ultra quality. We're gonna change it to back to auto. So we got it back on auto, and we'll run it one more time, and we'll see what we can get. All right. Well, I think that's a pretty good result, especially again, if we take into account we'd be 10 FPS higher if I wasn't capturing. That's crazy. And we're ray tracing. And if you see the number of frames, 2,578 last week with FSR, no ray tracing, the best number of frames I could get was like 3070. Like 3070 something. So it's absolutely nuts that like with ray tracing, the average FPS is like just as good as the normal FPS I was getting before, and the number of frames is still comparable to, no ray tracing. So, anyway, I hope you found this informative if you have an Intel Arc GPU. In a second here, I'm going to back out of the menus and I'll just drive around for a little bit. But I hope you liked the video. And if you did, go ahead and hit the like button and please consider subscribing. And now you can watch me hit stuff, but these are my settings. I'm going to turn ray tracing off because I don't personally play with ray tracing. Okay, we're gonna confirm. And yeah, I'm just gonna drive around for a little bit just so you can see what it's like if you did want to record some cyberpunk gameplay, whereas you could probably barely run the game before if you had an Arc GPU. Now it's really good performance. Especially in comparison.
Welcome to Info Flash.
All right, that's gonna do it for me. I'm gonna head out, let the footage play for a little bit of me just driving around and being a terrible driver. But I will see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.